Hello guys, I'm Jay and welcome back to a new video in which I'm going to review the Xiaomi Mi 10T. This is the base variant which is available for 36,000 rupees. This is not the Mi 10T Pro with 108 megapixel camera. This is the basic Mi 10T which comes with Snapdragon 865 processor, 144Hz refresh rate display, 5000mAh battery, 33W charging and a huge camera bump as well. Is this the best device to go for? Because at the price tag of 36,000 rupees, you can't really find great devices with Snapdragon 865 processor. Can the Mi 10T be one of the great ones? In this video, let's find it out. By the way, I have been using the Mi 10T as my primary device for the last 15 days. I bought it from Mi.com and I got a 1000 rupees off by using HDFC card basically. Without further delay, let's get started with the build quality. Back panel is basically a fingerprint magnet and you will have to use the case which is provided in the box or you will have to buy it separately. When it comes to build quality, the device is thick and it has weight to it. And if you have small hands, then this is definitely not the device to go for because it's not just heavy, but it's bulky as well. And when I'm saying bulky, yes, it's bulky. When you buy a flagship device, like let's say S20 FE, S20 Plus, OnePlus 70, 880, all these devices are flagship devices and they are not as bulky as Mi 10T. When you hold the Mi 10T for the first time, you will definitely notice that it's bulky. And not just that, it also has a huge camera bump. And when you place it on a table like this, it is going to wobble a lot. And this camera bump is surprisingly huge for an IMX682 sensor because I have seen other devices with the same camera sensor and those do not have such a huge camera bump. But one advantage of this huge build quality is that if someone comes to attack you, you can just throw the device towards them and it will definitely hurt them. It will hurt them. So you can use it for your own protection if it's needed, by the way. Next up, let's talk about the battery life. 5000mAh battery lasted me throughout an entire day without any issues. I shifted from Samsung Galaxy S20 FE to the Mi 10T and the change was very noticeable. I was getting about 3 to 3.5 hours of screen on time with the S20 FE. With this device, I was able to get 4 to 5 hours of screen on time very easily. And couple of times, I got 4 hours of screen on time on Mi 10T and in those scenarios, I was using the device to play PUBG Mobile on for 2 hours straight and even after that I got screen on time of 4 hours and once I was using the device to shoot a video, 1080p 30fps video for 2 hours and still I got a very good battery life. Basically battery life is something which I was very happy with after switching from S20 FE. I mean obviously I was going to be, if I would have shifted from devices like Redmi Note 9 Pro Max or Poco X3 then I would have felt like the battery life is okay, but after switching from S20 FE, I was like, excellent battery life. 33W fast charger, which is provided inside the box itself, will be able to get your device to 28% in just 15 minutes, 47% in 30 minutes, and 64% in 45 minutes, which is pretty good enough, I would say, for the 5000mAh battery, which is present inside the device. So these are some of the good things when it comes to network reception. I was very happy there as well. Dual 4G, dual voltage supported on this device. Obviously Snapdragon 865 processor, so I was expecting it to support that. No issues over there. When it comes to software experience, the device comes with MIUI 12 out of the box with Android 10 only. Other devices from OnePlus such as OnePlus 8, OnePlus 8T are already upgraded to Android 11. OnePlus 8T was launched in India or globally with Android 11 itself. Basically what that means is that if Xiaomi decides to give two major software Android updates to the Mi 10T or Mi 10T Pro or 3, let's go with that, then Android 11 will be counted as one software update, whereas the device was launched after Android 11 was widely available in the public. So that's something to note. And when it comes to software experience, did I see any ads? Did I see any spammy notification? Mi browser is not here. Indian government banned it completely. So that's not here. And that was the worst application. I'm glad that it's removed because it used to send a lot of notifications. That's not there. Zili application, which is something which I won't really recommend anyone installing in budget devices. That application is pre-installed and it sends notifications which are almost on edge of being vulgar. So that did not really happen on this device, but the app is installed. It's just that it doesn't send any notification. But there is one important thing to talk about here. K20, K20 Pro, when they were launched, they were also marketed as ad-free. But now if you reset your K20, K20 Pro, you will get an option of installing all these applications. Like I may not have screenshots of those right now, but it will you basically K20, K20 Pro were also promised to be ad-free, but they are not anymore. You get a lot of notifications from all the third-party applications. It's just that if you get the Meet & Tea, just uninstall Zili application or any application that keeps on sending notification, or disable notifications for those basically. Did MIUI perform really good in day-to-day life usage? Absolutely. Multitasking between apps, games, heavy games, doing anything did not hinder the performance at all. MIUI 12 was very well optimized on the Meet & Tea, and I enjoyed using MIUI 12. If you do not know, I like MIUI. I used to like MIUI at least very much. It was like one of the top most UI for me. But on this device, as there were not many ads, I enjoyed using MIUI 12. One downside is that it comes with Google Dialer and Google Messaging application. I'm not really sure why Xiaomi is doing this, because Xiaomi's own MIUI Dialer and MIUI Messaging applications are so great. Just add those back or give us an option to install those at least, because I personally prefer those. Call recording is something which I may not want, but a lot of people want. That's not present in the Google Dialer application as of shooting this video. At least it might be added in the future. Who knows? And I guess that's pretty much it for the software front. Now let's talk about gaming, because PUBG Mobile is coming back. PUBG Mobile India, 36,000 rupees price tag, 144Hz refresh rate, meaning if there is another game that you play which supports 144Hz refresh rate or 120Hz refresh rate, then this device will be very good for that. When it comes to PUBG Mobile, unfortunately, as of shooting this video, only smooth and extreme options were enabled on this device, and that has been the case with newly launched 865 powered devices. But I saw a 90fps option on the OnePlus 8T. If we get a 90fps option on this device, I'll be making another gaming review of this on my gaming channel, Dhananjay Gaming, which will be linked in the description box below, by the way. When it comes to gaming performance, the device did perform really good. PUBG Mobile at 60fps. The device was surprisingly able to keep 60fps. Like, the device was locked at 58, 59, 60, 58, 59, 60. It rarely dropped any frames, and that was quite surprising for us. And I would say I would give it a huge thumbs up from my side when it comes to gaming. At least if you're looking for a device with Snapdragon 865 processor, then this is definitely one of the best choices in the market right now, alongside OnePlus series of devices. I won't say this is better than OnePlus or IQ or anything. It's just that it matches their performance. Next up, we are going to talk about this 144Hz refresh rate. And this is not just 144Hz refresh rate display. This is LCD panel as well. Now, at the price tag of 36,000 rupees, a lot of people will straight up say, don't buy Meet & Tea because it doesn't have AMOLED screen. I'm not talking about tech reviewers as such, but in general, public usually says that no AMOLED means I will not spend more than 30,000 on that device. And in a way, that's not wrong actually, because you get a lot of options, literally a lot of options in this price segment, which come with AMOLED screen. Last year's K20 Pro, not even last year's, last year's K20 Pro launched with AMOLED screen, 60Hz. Maybe you could have given a 90Hz AMOLED screen on this device instead of 144Hz LCD screen. Before getting into AMOLED versus LCD, let's talk about how good the LCD panel is. It's fantastic. It is definitely one of the best LCD panels that you can get in the market right now. If you compare Poco X3's LCD panel and Meet & Tea's LCD panel, you will definitely notice difference that this is a flagship display which Xiaomi has provided. But if we talk about AMOLED versus LCD, because that's going to be the major talking point. Would you prefer a 90Hz AMOLED screen or 144Hz LCD screen? My answer would be, I would any day prefer a OnePlus 7T's 90Hz AMOLED screen over the LCD screen. See, I'll give you one real life example. I was watching a movie at night time, like it was entirely dark, and I was watching a movie. As the movie is not in 18:9 format or this display format, there were black bars, and I was able to notice that the black bars are not completely black. And I was like, I just moved from S20 FE, which has AMOLED screen and great AMOLED screen. I am going to use iPhone 12 mini, which also has OLED screen. So I was like, should I watch the movie on this device or should I watch it on my iPhone 12 mini? Because that's the device I'm testing and that has OLED screen as well. And I was like, I would prefer the OLED screen. Now, is this something which should stop you from buying the Meet & Tea? I don't really think so, but if you watch a lot of content, like a lot of YouTube videos, a lot of Netflix movies, then you should factor in this, because while watching movies, a 60Hz, 90Hz, 120, 144Hz display is not going to matter. Only the display technology is going to matter, and in that case, AMOLED will perform better as compared to the LCD panel present on the Meet & Tea. 144Hz refresh rate is great. I used it always on 144Hz refresh rate, and that's why the battery life was a little bit on the lower side, I would say. If I would have used 60Hz refresh rate, then the battery life would have gone to 7 hours, 6.5 hours very easily, in my opinion. Now, next up, let's talk about the cameras on this device. IMX682 sensor on this device did perform really good. I would say with the default camera, it would perform a little bit better as compared to 108 megapixel camera as well. Like, I mean, if you look into the details, obviously 108 megapixel camera of Mi 10T Pro will perform better, but Mi 10T did not disappoint by any means. I would rather say that the pictures clicked with the device were really good. I mean, at the price tag of 36,000 rupees, this is how the pictures should be. Even if I compare it side by side with other devices in the similar price segment, such as OnePlus 8 or OnePlus 8T, Mi 10T will still perform similar, if not better in some conditions. Not just that, when it comes to selfies, the device does have a lot of details. In night mode, the device did not disappoint here as well. It performed really good. So Mi 10T overall, when it comes to camera segment, did impress me. When it comes to videos, this is a video shot with ultra wide angle lens at 1080p at 30fps, and the video turned out to be really good. But is the video quality as good as S20FE, or is the camera as good as S20FE? Then I would say in photos, both of them are comparable, but in videos, S20FE was definitely better as compared to the Mi 10T, but it did shoot really good video. And I guess that's pretty much it for the review of Mi 10T. Now, should you buy this or should you skip it? It's not that easy. Because OnePlus 7T, OnePlus 8, OnePlus 8T are available in the similar price segment, even though 36,000 rupees is the pricing for the base variant, which is really good. In this price segment, you will get OnePlus 7T or OnePlus 8 with some card offer. So should you go for AMOLED screen or LCD screen? If I am spending that much money, criticism by people is not wrong, I would say. I would any day prefer to go with 90Hz AMOLED screen if I'm investing my money personally than going with 144Hz LCD screen. Even though the LCD screen is great, it's just that in some scenarios, AMOLED screen is just going to perform better no matter what. And that concludes. If you're looking for great performance, if you're looking to use a device with Xiaomi's MIUI 12 because it has ton of features, if you are looking for great camera system, good battery life and good charging support, then Mi 10T is the device to go for, in my opinion. And I guess that's pretty much it for this particular video. If you still have any more doubts, questions or queries regarding the Mi 10T or comparison of this device with any other device, do let me know about that in the comment section box below, or you can tweet it to me at @dhanjay_tech. If you enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you get notified next time I upload a video like this one. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.